I'm bored! Entertain me.
Hey, what's going on, motivators? My name is Cooper Russo, and I'm here to kill your boredom. We're going to do that today with the return of Ruby Chibi. They have season 3 out, which is awesome because, you know, we just finished up Ruby Volume 5, and it's so cool that they released Ruby Chibi so early. Last time we got the release of season 2 back in May, and, you know, it's really cool to get this early, and I'm going to suspect something. I think we might actually get a Valentine's Day special because this month is February. Before we jump into this episode of Ruby Chibi with the season premiere, I just want to point out a few things. First of all, you know, I just want to say I'm sorry, guys, for not posting any videos lately. It's just that I've been really busy at work. You know, I've been working, you know, double shifts. I got more hours now. I'm thinking about quitting my second job because the overtime I can make at my first job, it would be, believe it or not, be actually equivalent or more than what they're paying me now at my second job. So. So I just might be working one job, and that gives me more time to do the things I need to do as far as YouTube and personal stuff. And secondly, since I've been trying to catch up with a lot of things, you know, with changing my channel around, and I'm actually glad I did change the channel's name and outlook, because believe it or not, the channel actually shot up, a good amount of subscribers, and I think it might be because of the new outlook. And you know, the video I posted, you guys gave me a lot of support with that. You know, I got people asking me to react to their content now, which is really cool. And you know, that's also in my banner. If you guys go check it out, you'll notice in the bottom right hand corner it says, you know, your suggestions as one of the things I'm gonna be doing with the channel. So that's real cool. And yeah, I'm gonna get around to that. It's just that, you know, I've been really tired of work. I'm not ignoring you guys at all, trust me, it's never like that. And also, I've been reading up on this, my friends, is the Japanese hiragana and katakana for beginners. So the reason I'm reading up on this is because, for those of you who don't know this, my family and I were planning a big trip to Japan for the 2020 Olympics, and right now I'm just really reading up on the culture, the do's and don'ts of Japan, because we all saw what happened with Logan Paul. I don't want to get into that. You know, I already made a video on that. If you guys want to go check it out, by all means, go check it out. You know, just give my 2 cents on it. But yeah, you know, just to learn about the Japanese culture and, you know, the difference between hiragana and katakana. And then after this, I got to move on to kanji. Then I got to move on to actually speaking and having conversations in Japanese. So the cool thing about that book, I will say, is that, you know, once you learn and you know what each symbol means, you know, you start recognizing it, and you look at like Japanese font and text, you start to, you know, maybe not read it as what it translates to, but read it how you're supposed to read it out for each symbol. And you know, it kind of rewires your brain. So if anyone wants to learn hiragana and katakana, I would definitely recommend this book. About halfway through hiragana, but it really does rewire your brain. So secondly, as far as loot crate giveaways, we're waiting for all of our loot crates to get in. We're gonna do one massive unboxing video, and there's definitely gonna be a lot of cool stuff. And I already have an idea of who I want to select as winners as far as recent subscribers go. So there's that. And yeah, for those of you who don't know, we also have a GoFundMe page to help out with our trip to Japan. We're trying to raise, I know this sounds a little ridiculous, I know you guys probably call them BS on it, but we're trying to raise $10,000. And believe me when I say, all that money is going to go to our plane tickets and our hotel expenses. And if we have any money left over, it'll be any type of emergency fund. So believe me when I say that. And I'm also doing this because, you know, this year in June, it's either June or July, I got to find out the date, but our father retires from the military, which is going to be a big thing. And, you know, I'm doing this on his behalf, so that way he doesn't have to, you know, hash out all this money for plane tickets and hotel expenses. So it'll be like an easy burden off his shoulders. But, you know, we still got time to save up, but I'm hoping that, you know, something good comes out of that. And, you know, link in the description below if you guys want to go check out the GoFundMe page. Really not a whole lot, you know, I just put something together, you know, explain why we're doing this. And I know you guys, I know it's probably hard to convince you guys, you know, that this is what the money is for. Believe me, every cent that we make from the GoFundMe page will go to, you know, the Japan trip and nothing else. I promise you guys on that. We're not trying to con anybody, but I know all the horror stories with that. But yeah, for the most part, the reason I haven't been posting lately is just that, you know, I've been working a lot lately. So again, I'm going to be quitting my second job at the end of the month, and you know, I could just get, you know, a good amount of overtime in my first job. But anyway, let's jump into this episode. It's called Road Trip, and the thumbnail has Yang, Ruby, Blake, and Weiss all in a car, which is interesting because we've never seen Yang drive any other vehicle except Bumblebee. So it would be cool to see them go outside, outside the regular environment, because, you know, they've been traveling a lot in the later volumes. So it'd be cool to see them, like, go explore Mistral in Chibi form. And that's another thing I need to bring up. Also, because of my work schedule, I've been a little behind with some videos. So my top 10 characters I would like to see for Ruby Chibi is a little behind. And with that being said, guys, I'm going to work on that. And let's just jump on into this episode, because I'm really excited for this. And I can only imagine how Arnold is reacting to this. So without further ado, here's Ruby Chibi Season 3. I missed this dance! Ruby Chibi! Oh, man. Oh, they got everything packed and the guitar! What's Weiss doing?
Do I really need this? Or do I need
this? Oh, a little callback from Season 1. Oh, it kind of looks like my camera.
I feel like we're forgetting something.
What, Weiss? Oh, come on!
They left us again, didn't they?
Oh, they're always getting screwed.
Let's play some Rotu.
Oh, tater chips!
We're getting reports of a mysterious woman kidnapping hitchhikers for what is being described as nefarious reasons.
Aw, Cinder, really?
Who would be dumb enough to get in a car with a strange weirdo?
Gee, I wonder. God, all she needs is a white van.
Hello, victims. You boys look like you could use a ride.
Oh, come on.
I don't think that's a good idea, scary lady.
Oh, you know who she is!
Well, okay. But I've got...
Oh, come on. Jesus, Jean had to have been kidnapped so many times. All Cinder needed was a white van. Man up with port! That should be a Rooster Teeth series, Man Up with Port.
Unfortunately, not everyone is blessed with such deadly appendages. And sometimes, even someone as virile as me needs to use an actual weapon.
Man up with port! He would make an awesome gym teacher.
I'm going to teach you to make your own custom weapon.
Oh, cool.
Guard, villain.
There goes the tree again.
Oh, wait.
You'll need to gather metal.
Who's the cameraman?
The treacherous mountaintops, as well as wood from
Velvet!
Forbidden forests. Several pints of your
oh, God. Some oh, is she going to take a picture of his weapon?
But if you do
she
this,
is!
You'll have a one-of-a-kind manly weapon that...
Oh, she's just going to mock him now?
Well, sure, but it's not as manly as the real deal.
Oh, a mustache?
Oh, no one can oppose me and my
oh my God, I love Velvet so much.
Hey now, don't ridicule me.
Oh, and she can mimic other people too, like fighting styles. So that's a really cool play on that. I like that.
I'm going back in the bushes.
Respect the mustache.
The mustache.
Fasten your seatbelts, boys. It's gonna be a nefarious ride.
Oh, God.
It's a trap.
To catch a predator.
Safety locks, but we are neither children nor safe. Leave it to me. I think I can get us out of
here. Use your semblance.
We'll swim through lakes and climb up trees, catch fish, bugs, bears, and honey.
Oh, my God. Camp? Oh, and Miles does that voice, too.
That means I'm telling you.
Oh, my God.
We've got...
Oh, that is the best way to reference another show.
Who knew being annoying could actually come in handy?
I grew up with seven sisters. That's my only defense.
Next time we see the girls, they are in so much...
We should see his seven sisters.
How do you accidentally rob a...
Oh, my God.
I don't know, it all
happened so fast. Look, there's a roadblock ahead. Looks like we're gonna have a job.
Oh, come on, you have to end it right there. Road trip, mailing weapons. Oh, yeah, that's right. It's only two, technically. All right, discussion time. All right, guys, so good start off to the season. I can't wait to see where I have more with that. Sorry, I'm a little tongue twister right now. But, yeah, I didn't think that they were going to, you know, pull a twist on us with the whole camp thing. And I know I'm behind on those episodes. And trust me, guys, I'm going to get on top of that. But, yeah, you know, to see Velvet again and the fact that she's not only mimicking Port in the sense that, you know, her semblance allows her to do that, but she's just, like, straight up mocking him, which I think is a cool play on her ability. So, yeah, I'm just so glad to see this again. You know, I miss Ruby Chibi. You know, I'm already missing Ruby. But at the same time, you know, again, guys, thanks for your support with the channel. And, you know, just what everything you guys have said, you know, it really brings me up. My top 10 will probably be out next week. So, you know, I just been experiencing some technical difficulty, difficulties with that. Sorry, in Sony Vegas, it keeps like crashing on me. I don't know what's up with that. And we also got Death Battle next week too, so we got a top 10 for that as well. So to stay tuned for that. And again, guys, with our loot crates, we're gonna wait for all of them to get here, so they should be here by the middle of the month. We already got one of them. Now we're just waiting on DX, Loot Gaming, and Loot Anime. They had a lot of good stuff. Right now, they got a lot of good stuff too. So I'm not sponsored by Loot Crate at all, even though we like constantly order from them. But right now, they have a Valentine's Day special that's going on until the 14th. 30% off any monthly crate except for a special offer crate. So no World War II, Call of Duty crates, no Stranger Things crates, just regular Loot Crate, Loot Gaming, 30% off. And they're including 3 mystery items too, so that's pretty cool. So you guys want to check that out, go check out a Loot Crate. You guys like Ruby or Ruby Chibi stuff, make sure you subscribe to Rooster Teeth. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, please remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And again, guys, I can't thank you enough. I'm so glad I changed this outlook for my channel. I was scared at first, but there's a positive turnout with this. And if you guys want to go help us out with trying to get us to help us get to Japan, sorry, I'm tongue twisted by this friggin' episode. If you guys want to help us get to Japan, we'll leave a link to the GoFundMe page in the description below as well. So with that in mind, thanks again for everything, guys, and you guys have an amazing day, all right? Later.